Hello my friends, welcome back to Skyrim Thieves Guild. I have just made my way to the city of Markarth, which we have not been to yet in this playthrough. I have been to it off camera to get some speech training, which is available in this pub, the Silver Blood Inn. There is an old bard who hangs around in here who provides either expert or master level speech training. Seeing as how that's one of the most time consuming stats that I'm working on to level up, I've been doing it training 5 levels per level. No, he's a companion. It's this guy, Ogmund. I'd like training in the art of speech.
Well, you've come to the right place.
So, this should get us up to the next level. On to 52. It's starting to become very expensive. We might actually not have enough gold on us to train 5 times again. Let's just level up first. I am going to take... why is my stamina being drained? Oh, I think I have a disease of some sort. We can get to a temple and pray. There's some sort of temple here in Markarth, I believe. I can't remember exactly where, but it doesn't matter too much. Let's get health to 200, because that's... we're quite weak in combat at the moment, so I need to be focusing on that quite a bit. I'm going to take the Persuasion perk, which is massively useful at this point. 30% easier on Persuasion, which means that we'll probably succeed persuasion checks more than we fail them. Anyway, let's see if we can train again.
Well, you've come to the right place.
Yeah, we don't have enough gold to train for the 5th time, but I should be able to sell some stuff. I've got quite a bit of stuff that I'm carrying. This guy has very little in the way of dollar, but we'll sell him what we can anyway. There's a perk in the speech tree as well to sell any kind of item to any kind of merchant, which is one that we want.
Don't try to see for yourself.
58 gold. Don't take the piss. What have you got?
Are you looking for a gift for beautiful things for beautiful people?
Alright. The problem is that you have no money at all. I need to invest in these. Have I only got one lockpick? Oh, maybe some of them are stolen. Anyway, it doesn't really matter too much. We need to... I mean, there's some traders here. What's this? This is Arnleaf and Sons Trading Company. I'm going to try and keep this most of this sort of mercantile stuff.
We should get back to work. You there, if you're here to trade, step up to the counter.
You step up to the counter. Lisbeth.
No, I'm not Arnleaf. Trinkets.
I'm going to try and keep most of this mercantile stuff off camera as much as I can, just because... okay, you've got a bit more money. Just because... it's not very interesting, to be honest, and I have so many things that are worth so little that... that's pretty good. Hey, we got another point. Useful indeed. Elven armor, to be honest, it's not really as good. I mean, while it has very nice armor rating, we got that in just a leveled loot chest, so we're at the level now where we can be finding this stuff around and about in the world. I might as well sell it. It's just not really that useful. I'm not going to wear it, so... yeah. I do want to focus... once I've got speech nice and high, I'm going to focus increasing skills for training in light armor, because it takes so long to increase light armor as well. Fire salts... I'll keep them because I want to learn the alchemy ingredient from them. Forsworn bow... what do I have equipped? Wow, you buy lots of things. Alright, well, weak aversion to shock. Ulfa's book. Studded Imperial. Steel plate gauntlets. Yeah. Get rid of some of this good stuff. She's got 18 left. Ruined book. Wow, she's actually paying money for ruined books. That's useful. Stamina potions, I'll keep those. Petty soul gem, I'll keep. Nord barnacles, right, that'll do. Fine. What are we on? 903. Alright, so we're halfway there anyway. To that final speech check. So long as I remember to come back and... Speech check, speech skill training. So long as I remember to come back to Ogmund and train one
Excuse
more time.
Me, but do you know anything about this house? Seen anyone enter or leave?
No, I haven't.
Seems no one in this city has. I'm with the Vigil of Stendar. We believe this house might have been used for Daedra worship, evil rites, and so forth.
Do you need any help?
I was actually just about to head on inside. Be good to have someone watch my back. Follow me, and keep your eyes open. Daedra are powerful creatures and tricksters. Never know what you'll find.
The House of Horrors, this is a Daedric Prince quest. I'm not going in there. Like I said in the previous episode, I'm going to focus an entire series on Aedra and Daedra quests, aside from the one that we have to play in this quest line, which is Nocturnal's Daedric Prince quest. This is Understone Keep, which is the Jarl's Palace of Markarth. Markarth is an interesting city because it's an old dwarven ruined city that's, rather than being a dungeon like all the other dwarven ruins, it's been inhabited by, you know, modern people and has kind of just been turned into one of the five major cities in the game. So it has a very unique style. And, yeah. In here is Calcelmo's laboratory. He's the guy that we need to speak to regarding getting information about, it escapes me now. What is it? Let's have a look. Falmer. The Falmer writing.
What are you hiding, priest?
I'm not hiding anything. It's closed for a reason.
Typical Imperial lies. First, you take away Talos. Now you're keeping us from seeing our honor dead? You and the Jarl will answer for any...
Don't bother with Tacitus. Useless.
No offense, but you're not looking so good. Are you feeling ill?
Right, so what they were talking about... Hi, Tacitus. What they were talking about is, the Hall of the Dead in here has been shut off, and does not have public access. He mentioned that the Imperials took away Talos. That's because of an agreement. In between Oblivion and Skyrim, there was this big war between the Empire and the Aldmeri Dominion, which is this kind of fascist dominion of high elves from the Somerset Isles. And they had this huge war in between the two games, and the peace treaty was kind of signed between them with a number of like caveats and sort of agreements, and one of them was that Talos would not be recognized as one of the nine divines, and so that's why in this one there are only eight divines. What are you carrying? Ooh. Keita Nshwandzel. I take your stuff.
What are you doing here? The excavation site is closed. I don't need any more workers or guards.
Excavation sites?
Nshwandzel? The ruins underneath Markarth? The wealth of artifacts that I've based two human lifetimes of research on? You idiot! Do you even know who I am? the most recognized scholar on the Dwemer in all of Tamriel. And you people keep bothering me. I'm sorry, I got too excited. I'm in the middle of some very stressful work, and I shouldn't have yelled. How can I help you?
I hear you're the authority on ancient Falmer.
Then you were well informed. I am at this very moment on the cusp of completing my magnum opus on the subject. I'm calling it Calcelmo's Guide to the Falmer Tongue. It will revolutionize the way we understand those ancient beings.
Perhaps I could view your work.
Preposterous. That research represents years of personal toil in some of the most dangerous Dwemer ruins in Skyrim. You must be mad to think I'd allow anyone to see it before it's completed.
Forget it. Maybe I'll come back later.
Very well. Perhaps when my research is complete, I'll feel more comfortable discussing my findings with you.
Gain entry to Calcelmo's museum. Well, we already have entry because I've just stolen his key. So, what's along here? Can't really remember this too well. Nuan Shell excavation site, I already have the key to that as well. He's so focused on his work, he doesn't feel my hands rifling through his pockets and taking all of his valuable shit. So he's talking about that he's the foremost authority on Falmer and stuff like that, but also he's... The Falmer, law-wise...
Halt! The Dwemer Museum isn't open to anyone without the court wizard's permission.
Why can't I go in?
Because Calcelmo doesn't want anyone to go in. He runs the museum. He makes the rules. You have a problem with that? Go talk to him. You'll find him in front of the ruins during the day, just down the tunnel.
Okay. Are you going to stop me if I walk past you? Of course you're not. You're too stupid. So yeah, the Falmer are explored lore-wise in a few quests in Skyrim. One in particular, which is the longest quest in the entire game and was added by the Dawnguard DLC, is called Lost to the Ages. And it's one of the very, very best quests in the entire game, and we will get to that in the future. I'm probably going to do a side quest series, but... Alright, we need to be a bit careful here. Now, somewhere in here is the item for Delvin. It is a Dwemer puzzle cube. I can't remember exactly where it is, so we're going to have to be somewhat methodical. Let me just see what I'm... Okay, I've got 90-odd carry weight. So, there's some fairly valuable stuff in here. Yeah, I've got 7 picks. So we may as well open some of these things and see if there's anything valuable inside. Ooh, books. They could be skill books. Frontier Conquest? Nope. The Falmer, a study. Nope. Fall of the Snow Prince. So they're all things on Falmer as well. The Snow Prince was the old prince of the Falmer who was defeated by the Nords in a war or something like that. Falmer Shield. Oh god.
By order of the arms.
Okay. Well, I guess we need to be a bit more careful then. So there are 3 guards that I can see. An expert case. What's inside this? Can I get inside this with 7 picks? Yes. A dwarven dagger. Oh dear. Okay, it must have been him who saw me. Solid Dwemer metal. There's got to be some skill books in here somewhere. Balls. War of the First Council. Is that a skill book? Nope. On the Great Collapse? Nope. Nerevar, Moon and Star. That's a valuable one-ish. The Seed. Oh dear. Yeah, right, I'm thinking to just sack these display cases off and try and focus on getting through this place. I seem to recall that the Dwemer puzzle cube thing that I'm looking for in here was... Oh dear. Now he's seen me. Right, we'll go around that side and avoid his patrol then. I think seems to remember that the Dwemer puzzle cube was like in a place just through this room before you get to the other side of the area. Oh, he saw me again. Right. I'm gonna go wait for him to turn around and go behind his patrol line along the wall. We can always come back to this place later on and pillage it. If I see anything particularly valuable, I'll take it, but that expert display case only held a dwarven dagger inside, so there really isn't much point in doing this right now. Oh god, why is he coming this way? He didn't go that way last time. I'm legit like... I thought they had set patrols. Seems to fly in the face of all other stealth games ever made if the guards have random patrol routes. Right. Calcelmo's... Oh, it's in here, the puzzle cube, I think. I can't remember if there are guards in here or not. Be a bit more thorough in here than I was. There's oil on the floor. I can see soul gems. Can't see any guards or... spider control rod. Whoa. Does this like... can I use this anywhere else but here? I don't remember this item. It's a weapon. Directs Icantar's spider to the target. Are you going to follow me around? I really don't remember this item at all. Icantar's lab journal. Lots of stuff here, feel free to pause and read that. I'm not especially worried about reading it out in the video, it'll take ages. I'm going to equip this and see if Right, it has charge, so... So I don't want to waste that charge on it, but... It looks like we can command this spider here. Oh god. What the hell? Who's that? Wizard's guard. Right, so this spider appears to be a bodyguard now. Yeah, I don't... Do I lose a bonus if these people die because of the robot kills them? Because... I mean, he doesn't really have... He's got steel armor, I suppose that's worth a fair bit. I could probably just pickpocket it, though. What I'll do, right, I'm going to do this... I'm going to load the autosave at the start of this area, and, see if I can avoid these guys being killed. I do kind of want that control rod thing. So the spider comes out of there when I take the control rod. I could take it last, I guess. There are patrolling wizard's guards that we know of in here, so... I'm just going to be quite careful. There's a couple of them over there. Where are they going? Huh. Steel horned gear is worth a fair bit. If I can pickpocket it from them, that will be useful. Anything in here? Nope. Absolute shite. Some sort of bedroom. Dwemer history and culture. Dwemer gyro. Apprentice display case. Again, I'm just looking in case any of these are skill books. Dwarves Volume 1. Dwarves Volume 2. Dwarves Volume 3. No. Nightshade. I'll take the gold, I guess. Calcelmo's lab key, another one. We already have it. Scroll of courage, scroll of firebolt, scroll of candlelight, magic of poison, or potion. Yeah, so... I do have some invisibility potions or other, I think, as well. Or scrolls or something. I don't really see that there's much point... Oh, God. You have committed crimes against Skyrim, and he didn't even... I didn't even get, like, the detective thing then, so that's kind of bullshit. Still. At least the stealth actually works in this game to some extent, unlike Oblivion, where it was completely broken. Same with bows. Bows and arrows in Oblivion were just... Like, marksman builds in general were not viable in that game without mods, which was, frankly, ludicrous, because it was like, you've built loads of different things. Like bows and arrows and stuff into the game. I've been seen, haven't I?
That's close enough.
Right, the guards just bait straight up run at you.
I guess I was just hearing things.
I mean, like the Markarth guards do. I've got a bit of bounty, but that's fine. I can.
You have committed crimes against Skyrim and your people.
No.
What say you?
So, if you're seen by the like city guards, then they basically just their AI just beelines for you, and you can't stop them from arresting you on the spot. Whereas the wizards guards, you can game like anything else, and you can kind of. You know, if they're like alerted but they haven't directly seen you, then you can hide and become hidden again. So as long as you aren't seen by these, you're all right. The one behind is no problem. It's the city guard guy that's the problem. Right. We're in.
What do you think this is?
Another trap, most likely. Is it dangerous? Three of the guards died when the lower hall flooded with steam last week.
Steam traps. Oh yeah, these are blade traps. I can't remember where the trigger is, but as long as it doesn't kill the guards when I set them off, that's fine. I really can't remember where I'm going here, but that's a trigger. Okay, there's some sort of poison gas in here, which is, oh my crikey, that is draining my health very, very quickly. I could try. Have I got any potions left? Plentiful healing, we use one of them. I'm forward rolling through this all. Okay. That was pretty fucking nasty. What's actually through here, if anything? I've just gone round in a big circle, haven't I? Was this where I went the first time? I actually don't know. Alright, this is in the right direction, but do you know that I need to find this puzzle cube as well? I mean, I can't. Cure disease potion. I'm going to use that straight away. Stop my stamina being drained. Luckily, I'm regenerating health at a fair lick, so. You can stop and turn back, yes you are. In that case, I will wait for you to move. Presumably you are going to move. Yes you are. To get very quickly behind you before you turn back, thank you. Alright, what's in here? A guard. Someone sat down. I could probably gas these guys with that valve. You got anything? The same stuff. Oh dear.
Never should have come here.
Yeah, that's no good. Right, we should just be able to avoid these guys altogether then. I don't really want to kill them. I don't really mind about killing them. My character is quite amoral, but it would be easier not to.
I'm getting out of here.
Huh? Hmm. You've seen nothing, mate. Nothing at all.
Anybody there?
I remember this being the place with the puzzle cube, the room of the enchanter's table. Just need to get back to the hidden state, and then he should go and sit down again, probably. All right.
Must be my imagination.
Here it is. Yoink. Now that enchanter's table, I might actually use that on the way back if there's no shortcut back, just because I haven't actually done any enchanting yet. That's a nice skill to kind of increase in the background of the other ones, just to get you some level ups, because I need to do some power leveling after this quest. The Wizard's Balcony. Which overlooks the city of Markarf, and this leads to Calcelmo's tower, where whatever it is that we need is located. Are there going to be any guards in here? Doesn't look like it. How do we get up there? Through here, probably. Alright. That centurion looks like it might come to life, even though I don't think it will. Anything valuable in here? Soul gems, I'll take them. Ah, arcane enchanter. So, what we can do is disenchant some things. That's my main weapon, so I'm not going to take that. I will do this, Soul Snare, because then we can apply the effects to something else. Frost. Yeah. We could destroy that unique item. It's only like fur armor. Yeah, let's do that. Wielding. Smithing. Magicka. Deft Hands. And Squire is light armor. Yeah, we definitely want that. Okay, so I've leveled up again, so I need to not actually apply the level up until I've trained another time. I need to remember to not go into the skills menu. Can I do any alchemy while I'm here? Might as well just quickly do some. Okay. We did the fire salts, so we learned their effects. Alright, I think we're just about done. We can probably take those. We can probably move on to get this finished now. What's this? Calcelmo's stone. You don't have the items required to make a copy of the inscription. Hmm. What do I need? Paper and charcoal, probably? I can't remember. It's been so long since I've played this questline. Roll of paper, some charcoal, I guess. Let's try that. Is that enough to write it all down? Oh no, we can do a rubbing. Yeah, like in Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade. There we go.
Yes, I'm positive.
Calcelmo's stone rubbing. Is it miscellaneous? Yeah. Can't read it. It's just like for show. Okay. Oh god.
Alright. If there is a thief, He won't leave this tower alive. But shouldn't we inform Master Calcelmo?
I'll deal with my uncle.
What was that?
Well, yeah. I mean, I could run for it. I'll just do that, I think. I could try just running for it. I mean, they're going to follow me, like, but... Do I have reach bounty for that? Stats. Crime. I think I just got bounty for that. Try doing that again.
I'll deal with my uncle. Just go. Scour this place from top to bottom.
To get around this way would be good. If I can do that. So there, most of them are going up stairs that way. This guy is going to like go and guard the door. Conveniently, there are walkways just above him. Nice. I've played Dishonored, I know to look for walkways up above. Let's just quick save. There might be more guards on this walkway now. I think you can jump off here and like land in water, if I remember rightly. Oh no, maybe not. This might be a yeah, there's a waterfall you can jump down. I'm sure there is. I remember. I'm sure you could get down there or somewhere right round here. There was a way, a quick way down. It doesn't matter really, does it? Nah, it doesn't matter. Do just need to sell some more stuff somewhere to get that speech training back up. There's people everywhere. And creep around these pipes. Okay. It's really annoying me that, oh god, it's really annoying me that I can't remember, like, how to jump down that waterfall, because you can definitely do it.
I need some help in here.
And now I've got to go all the way through this, like, the long way back. Still, it doesn't really matter, does it? That silent forward roll, I can't really remember exactly how it works, but it's not working that well for me, to be quite honest.
What was that?
Go this way. It just seems to be sort of a way to move very quickly in sneak mode. Back to your stations.
I was sure I heard something.
Is this a way out? This wasn't the way through that poison gas trap again. Oh, okay, yeah, I remember. This is...
I remember. Remember the blade trap? Remember the gas trap? I remember.
Yeah, I think this is the way out. No, this is the way to the gas trap. That's no good. Right. I remember the blade trap thing was on the left as I came through, so... Maybe it was, like, here? Nah, but there's a... Oh, a master chest. Guess it's worth a try. I've only got 5 picks, but 4 picks. Right. This is very optimistic play here, but... Shit. Last chance. Come on. Oh, balls. Try that again. I want to see what's inside this. Probably be leveled, but if it's master leveled, it should still have something worth money inside. We've not really got anything worth money yet in this, so. Beep. The location of the point of leverage is random each time, so it's not going to be in the same place. Yeah, I don't have enough skills invested in lockpicking. The picks break far too easily. Oh god. Okay, so maybe this was the other end. Yeah, this is right, okay. I was at the other end of the blade trap. Garlic. What the fuck? Well, this isn't fucking fair, is it? Beep. Yeah, no good. No good at all. Maybe I could try using an invisibility potion to get around this. How are you, like, suspicious? Okay, right. So long as... Oh, right, they aren't walking together. So yeah, the problem is that it's just this guy. So long as I can stay out of the way of him, the other one doesn't really matter. But... a potion of invisibility might be good. Brief invisibility. 20 seconds, that'll do. As long as he doesn't hear me, that's fine. Now, invisibility and chameleon in Elder Scrolls games are two different things. Invisibility grants you total invisibility for the time stated, which is just worn off, provided that you don't interact with anything. If you, like, pickpocket someone or open a door or search a container, the invisibility wears off immediately and you're, like, instantly sort of given away visually. Chameleon is a different thing. That's something that has, like, a percentage. And so 10% chameleon renders you, like, blends you into your environment sort of 10%, which makes you 10% harder to see no matter what you're doing. So if you can combine different items and spells to grant yourself like 100% chameleon, it means that you can just walk around completely freely of being detected. You can just stand in front of people's faces and they'll just stare right through you and never see you. So in Oblivion, I would just like to, you always just break the game by making enchanted equipment and get like a full set of light armor and just enchant each piece of it with like 20 points of chameleon. It just meant that you could walk up to someone and stab them with your sword and they still wouldn't see you. They just stand there and take it, and it was very broken. You've seen nothing, mate. Right. We're all good. Marakarth. We no longer need to sneak. So, what do we have to do with this? Do we have to take it back to... Enthir? Is he the guy in Winterhold? Yes. So we need to get a carriage back to Winterhold. If there's anywhere else here that I can buy some items, sell some items and get that speech training point, that will be very useful indeed.
Don't think you can barter with me like one of those damned shopkeepers.
I'm looking for damned shopkeepers. So we've been in there, we've already spent all their money. There's got to be more shops around. I can't remember the layout of this place at all. I guess we could try going in. It'll be locked now, won't it? Yeah. Let's wait for like 5 hours so we can see if they've got any money back. Otherwise, I may have to go to like Whiterun or something and sell some stuff there and then go back to Markarth and train and then go back to Winterhold.
No, some may call this junk.
Yeah, you don't have any money back.
Come back whenever you need something.
I mean, there will be other traders in this town. I just can't remember where they are. Let's see on the local map. Lindral Hall. Silverblood Inn. Guard Tower. Let's just have a quick look round. Then I might just end the episode. This is like this sort of weird mining area underneath, around this side. Something there. Let's see. What's this? The Hag's Cure. This is like a potion shop, so probably not going to be able to make very much money here, but still better than none.
Better than none.
Hello.
The Hag's Cure is here for all your discreet needs. Ah, so you're an alchemist then.
No, but I have some stuff you may be interested in. You only have 500. They're quite useful. Can sell that valuable Ice Wraith stuff. Sell those. Right, we've nearly got enough.
Now. You let me know if you need a cure or anything else.
You...
There's so much to learn about the shop. I'll never get it all straight.
You are familiar to me. Oh, yes. She's she's part of the Dark Brotherhood questline, which we will get to in due course. You have to, like, kill someone for her, and then she then becomes a potential marriage partner. I remember it because in the very first playthrough I did of Skyrim, when I decided to marry someone, I married her, and there's kind of it's not really a bug, it's more of an oversight. But she's like, when you've killed the person that she wants killed, like the contract, when you've completed her quest, she goes, to this point where basically she says as a greeting, thank you for taking care of my problem or something like that, and if you marry her, she still says it every time as a greeting. But yeah, there you go.
I'm gonna be a silversmith one day.
Have I actually exhausted all these vendors? I think I have, haven't I? Alright, well, let's try waiting for 24 hours. See if they get any money back that way. They probably don't. I seem to remember that they don't, but it's worth knowing this. If they don't, we'll end the episode. Just be very useful to get that final speech training point in before I inevitably open the skills menu by accident and level up.
My wife Kira runs our jewelry again.
You have no money. 50. Okay, he seems to be replenished, so hopefully this person will be. Because this will get us enough for that final point.
No, I'm not. Some may call this junk.
Yeah, she's got some. Okay, what can we sell? Sell the Forsworn bow, some garnets, goat hide, gold necklace, gold ruby necklace, hide helmet, ancient battle axe, ice wolf pelt, imperial bow, that'll do. Now we should be able to finish this off. Then what I'm going to do now, I think that might have been Ogmund going in, which is perfect. So I'll level up now and then I'll end the episode. In between this episode and the next one, I'm going to do some power leveling.
What can an old skull do? Well, you've come to the right place.
Okay. Stamina, I guess. I'll leave the perk for next time.
Good fighting to you.
Right, I'm going to end this episode here. Next time we will go and turn in this quest and start the next one, but I need to do some power leveling in between for reasons which will become apparent in the next one. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Skyrim Thieves Guild. If you did, drop me a like, and I'll see you next time for more of it. Take care and goodbye.